Thank you. Thank you. We've talked about poker before, and Robin, I saw you shuffle. I think you're a poker player, aren't you? You know poker, right? I wanted to try something, because a lot of people say to me, Harry, if you use this in a game, you've got the whole deck of cards. Can you do this? I'm taking out separate cards here. I'm not trying to do anything funny. I'm taking out a few cards. You'll see why in a minute. Can you do this with maybe only 10 cards and play head-to-head poker? You see, that way we know that you can't possibly cheat. Because if you were to surreptitiously add a card, we'd know it. There'd be one extra card. If you were to surreptitiously take away a card from those 10, again, we would know it because there would be one card short. That's why I want to try this. And I'm trying to take out 10 cards. Robin, you're a good poker player. I saw that before, right? And I'm taking out only 10 cards. I want to make sure I've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. I do have, I don't like this card. Let me get one other card here. And you'll see why in a moment. Okay, I think we could use, what the heck, why not use this? All right, there are only 10. I know when I do this, I know you don't trust me. Let me prove to you that there are only 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 cards. Now what we're going to do is we're going to play head-to-head poker, Robin. The idea is to see if you could beat me. Thank you. Okay. Just as an example, and I'm going to deal them out straight now just so you know what's going on. Look at your cards, see what you have, lay it down, whatever you have that you think wins, and let's, all you have is a pair of fives. Well, I have kings, obviously beats the five. So that's the idea, but I want you to try to win, all right? Now, it's a little difficult to shuffle a small packet. It really is, but as you can see, they're being shuffled. Let's try this. You take the cards in your own hand, start to deal, and we're going to do something that's never been done before, right? Shuffle the stock, the cards you have in your hand, the terminology is stock, and then deal out another round apiece, which means a card apiece, and then shuffle again and keep doing that. The only thing I'm going to ask is the last two cards you have to deal out straight, okay? So deal another card apiece, shuffle them, and deal them out, and mix those two. I said you have to deal them straight. If you want to mix them, you can. And now let's see what you have. Let's see if you've won, which is what I want you to do. What have you got? Only fives again. Well, you've given me kings again. I want you to follow this now, Robin. I want you to win, okay? So try. Look, again, we're going to shuffle the cards. And as I told you before, and it's true, it's difficult to shuffle a small packet. Let's try this. Take out any card. Would you, Robin? Take out a card. Yeah, anyone at all. You take out a card for her. Any card. Give it to her. Don't let me see. Give it to her. Take out another. You've got two. Take out three more from anyway. I don't care where you want those three. That's up to you. I've let you take your own cards. Let's see what you've done. What have you got? Kings? No, you gave me aces. I don't think you understand, Robin. I want you to win. That's the whole point of this. I know what we'll do. Look, you can see that these few cards, as I say, very hard to shuffle. I'm shuffling. I'm gonna try the best I can. Look, they're being shuffled as best I can. Take the cards. Doesn't really matter if they're shuffled. You'll see why. Deal out a card apiece. Now stop. We're gonna pretend that you can deal seconds. If you don't know what that means you can deal the second card and make it look like it's the top card. Since you can't do that, at least I hope you can't, I'm going to let you look at each card. Now, if you want to give it to me, give it to me. If you don't, you take it. We'll pretend you can deal second. So take a look at that card, give it to whoever you please. Now, I'm going to leave it to you. Look at the next card. Whoever you want to give it to. Now, you can give me two or three at a time, or you can take two or three in a row, as long as we end up with five cards each. So you give that to whoever you please. All right, you gave me two in a row. Look at the next card. Incidentally, if you're not sure, you can put that back, shuffle, and get a different card. I don't want to kill you with decisions. So you really can do that if you want. But you've made up your mind, right? All right, look at, who do you want to give that to? Remember, you can shuffle if you can mix them up if you want to. Yeah. Oh. Now mix them. See, I don't want you to, mix them up. Look at the next card. Who do you want to give it to? All right, you've got three, and that's fine. Look at the next card. You can take two if you want to. Who do you want to give that to? All right, we get one card apiece, I think. Or no, you have to get, I get one, you got two more coming. All right, look at the next card. Who do you want to give it to? Okay, you got to give me the last one. All right, now I've let you look and I've let you do it. Let's see what you've got. Two pair. No. You gave me three kings. I don't think you're paying attention. I want you to win. Look, let's try it this. You know what I think it is? I think it's a memory problem. It really is. Because you were putting down the cards and you didn't remember who you gave what. So let's do it this way. Again, I'm trying to shuffle these cards. They've gotten a little sticky. But you take them. We'll play stud poker. That will solve the problem because you can see cards. So you don't, it won't be a memory problem. Deal out the two whole cards first, if you would. Yep. The whole cards go down. But I'll tell you what, as long as you ask me, I'm going to let you see see mine. I don't want you to see yours yet. I'm going to let you see mine. But now you can do what we did before. You've got an edge now. You know my whole card. Look at the top card. Give it to whomever you please. But now we're going up. So, oh, naturally. I think a bit off my, yeah, well, me and my big mouth. Oh, okay. Wait. Just a minute. I want you to understand something. You only got one more card coming. If you take one more card, you're going to have to give me the rest. Remember, we have to end up with five apiece. So if you like, look at the next card. If you don't like it, you can shuffle it. That's up to you. And get it, you know, face up. So you, that way you can remember. Thanks a lot. A lot of good that does me. Let's see what else you've got. You're going to give me two kings. She's the first one ever did that. I think I'm in trouble, folks. Yeah, where do you want to? You want to shuffle them. I don't want you to know where they are. Yeah. Who do you want to give that to? Oh, thanks. Okay. We got a card apiece coming. Give it to whoever you like. Give it to whoever you like. Well, I think that's a smart move. Let's see the next. Ooh, what have you got? Turn up your whole. What have you got? You gave yourself three aces, but you gave me a full house. I don't understand. No, wait a minute. Look, I'll tell you. Just to put this more on the legitimate side, look, because people usually ask me, can you do it with only 10 cards? Then they say, wait a minute, can you do it with the whole deck? Can you do the same thing with the entire deck? Well, I just put these cards back. Do me a favor. Will you shuffle these up for me? Really, give them a good mixing, would you? I saw you mix before, and you're very good. Good mixing. And the deck, of course, is being shuffled. You can see that. Put the cards back on. Since the cards are mixed, we don't have to do any of these unique things like looking at the cards. You've mixed the cards. Pick them up and deal out a regular poker hand between me and you. Would you do that without anybody looking at cards? Here's the point. If you've shuffled those cards and you're dealing them out, you know this, you all know it, if you're poker players, only one of these hands can win. There are no draws, there are no ties in poker. So you know that there's a 50-50 shot. My question, Robin, if I were to put down $100 right now against your dime, would you take that bet that I've got you beat? Now, I'm not going to touch those cards. I will put down $100 to your dime. We're just making believe. Of course, we're pretending. Would you take that bet? Mm-hmm. You would? Then you're a lousy gambler because you just lost a dime. Take a look at your hand. See what you've got. I don't want to touch it. What have you got? Pair of kings. Take a look at my hand. Lay them down so everybody else can see them. Did you just lose a dime? Okay, good enough. Just wanted to show you. All right. All righty. Thanks.